together, that whole camaraderie is intrinsic to the music. There would be no Van Halen without that.
If you would like to send us a letter asking a question or making a statement or whatever you'd like to say, you can send it to ddunchainedpodcast@gmail.com.
Melbourne.
My name is Noel Monk. I'm the former manager of Van Halen from 78 to 85. You guys are lucky to be listening to Dave and Dave Unchained.
Hi, I'm Jackie Martling. My brand new autobiography, The Joke Man, Bout of Stern, is being released. Go to JackieTheJokeMan.com. Great holiday gifts. Easy to wrap. I guarantee you are going to love this book.
I don't ever want to do the same thing over and over again. Like, you know, a reality show is just like, oh my God. I'd get so bored with cameras being in my face all the time. But I do like the idea of moving into a different type of celebrity, you know, instead of going out and trying to make it as a singer, songwriter, musician, rock star. I feel I look stupid doing that right now. You know, I do it out of love, that I love to do it, and for my fans. But to go out there and like act like I'm trying to make it and trying to, you know, become, you know, some big rock star or something is like embarrassing to me. It's like, I'm sorry, folks. I'm sorry I'm still doing this because I really do like it. That's why I'm doing it. You know, I don't need money, I swear, you know.
Okay. Well, Dave, as you know, it is Thanksgiving time, and that means we got to put a bird on the plate. This month, we are going with chicken instead of turkey. In fact, it's going to be chicken foot. So it is winner, winner, chicken foot dinner this time around. And Dave and I are going to talk about the debut album of Chickenfoot, which came out in 2009. So as we dial back into the past, it is 2008 and Sammy Hagar is post Van Halen 12 years. And after banging out several solo albums with the Wobberitas, the Red Rocker was itching to be in a band again. So in 2002, he called up his old buddy Neil Sean of Journey, who he was in the band HSAS, if you remember that, back in 1983. They had that EP. What was it called? Through the Fire, right, Dave?
Well, it was a full album. It wasn't an EP. It was a full-blown album.
I thought it was an EP.
No. There's at least like 8 to 10 songs on that album. That's
Are
not
you
an EP.
Sure?
I am very sure. Okay. That's a full-blown album.
Regardless, he did a release with HSAS. He was looking to possibly rekindle some of that old magic, you know? He got a little horny, so he called his old girlfriend. So Sammy brought along a bassist, Michael Anthony. And Sean brought along his drummer, Dean Castronovo, who was in Journey at the time. Dean is an incredibly talented guy, even though he's had some troubled past with the law. He certainly is an incredible vocalist and drummer. So
right.
The band recorded two songs, Psycho, Vertigo, and Peephole, but they weren't really released until later in different forms. So what happened was the band was called Planet Us. And things got a little dicey. So things got delayed to early 2003. Dean was recovering from an illness. And then the band got interrupted in 2004 by the Van Hagar reunion. Neil Sean started to get a little pissed off. He wanted to go full steam with this Planet Us. He was very excited about it. He was writing all these songs and he had everything going. And so then he ended up doing an album called Soul Circus. And it was Soul, S-O-U-L, and then Circus, S-I-R-K, and then he would put U-S in caps. So it was
right.
Almost like a new version of Planet Us. And he had Dean on drums and himself on guitar. And he brought in Jeff Scott Soto, everybody's favorite replacement singer, on vocals and Mark Mendoza on bass. And then he also brought in Virgil Donati. So he put this band together. And the song Vertigo was supposed to be on the Spider-Man soundtrack when they recorded it with Sam. but it got rejected for being too heavy. The song Peeping Through a Hole, which turned out to be Peephole, I guess when Soul Circus did it on their album Wordplay, that was also recorded. Apparently there are two recordings that who knows where they are, but they haven't been released of the actual Planet Us versions of those songs. So now,
yes, they have. They're on the Sam solo album. What's it called? Cosmic.
Right. Fashion. But right. Cosmic. But are they the actual versions?
I think so.
I thought they were re-recorded.
I was always under the impression they were the original versions.
Okay. We'll have to check into that. If I remember, I was going to mention that very shortly. I thought they both kind of went their own way and did their own versions. Like, I know Peephole was on Wordplay, the Soul Circus album.
And then
Sammy, I know, did something with Vertigo, but I thought he did his own version. I don't think he re-released.
No, I think he took those two songs and he put them on, what's it called, like Cosmic Universal Fashion or whatever that album
it's
is.
Actually like his most least popular solo album, at least post
Well, that's
Van Halen.
It. That album is a whole hodgepodge of like leftover stuff.
Yeah.
But the Soul Circus album is phenomenal.
Yeah, that's a great album. Yeah.
And I recommend that to any and everybody. That's really a well-done album that didn't get enough press or attention, but it is really, really good.
You wonder what Sean's relationship is with Sam now, because they've known each other forever. I mean, they've been buddies since like the early 70s, so I don't know if they're on good terms, bad terms, or what the story is.
Well, I think they must be on somewhat good terms, because I think Neil showed up on another Sammy album. Didn't he show up on the Sammy and Friends album?
Yeah, he might have.
I think he did Going Down. It was him. Oh, you know what? It was almost another version of Hassas, except it was him and Mikey and, now I'm trying to remember who the drummer was. I think it was the Chickenfoot drummer, actually.
Chad?
I think it was Chad. Yeah, I think it was
really?
Chad. If memory serves me correctly. Yeah. But so I think he's still friendly enough with Neil that they, you know, they do some stuff from time to time.
Well, they're both from San Francisco. I mean, they've known each other forever. So I don't know. But, you know, we'll see. So enter Chickenfoot. So this started when Chad Smith of the Red Hot Chili Peppers, the drummer from the Chili Peppers, started jamming with Sammy and Michael at Cabo Wabo. And apparently it was Chad who was pushing to go on tour and really do something serious. And then Sammy Hagar contacted Joe Satriani, who he called the best guitarist in the world. Chickenfoot joined Sammy on stage in Las Vegas in like February of 2008. And they did a set where they played like a bunch of covers like Zepp's Rock and Roll, Dear Mr. Fantasy from Traffic, and Going Down, that song. Now, the band is a little tricky because they have to balance everybody's schedules. Now, we all know Mike's got an open calendar, but
right.
And you know, Joe can sort of control his own stuff because he's got a solo career. But obviously, Chad is in the Chili Peppers, which is a big band, and they had to dance around that. So that was a little tricky.
Right. But at the time, though, and correct me if I'm wrong, Dave, but when Chickenfoot was being formed, wasn't that when the Red Hot Chili Peppers were between guitarists and they weren't quite sure what they were doing?
Chad actually
had time on his hands.
They did, but it's like the Chili Peppers are weird, man. They have so much space between albums. It's crazy. Sometimes they go on tour and then they go off and play in other countries and stuff. It's a little weird. So it's a little hard. Like, I know Chad does a lot of like studio work. For example, Chad just fucking played drums on the whole new Ozzy album.
I saw that.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah,
I mean,
he is one of these guys who has to keep busy. He's
right.
always doing
no,
something.
He likes to keep busy, and that's great. But going on tour and playing in a studio are two different things. Like, he could knock out that Ozzy album in a couple of weeks, whereas, you know, it might be a little trickier for him to, you know, like, you know, go on tour with, like, Chickenfoot and commit to a band, so.
Oh, yeah, no, he's not touring that much, but he is always playing on one studio album or another, whether it's a guest appearance or his own side projects or things like that.
Absolutely. Chad's an excellent drummer, and he is certainly a man in demand. So, but what they did was they went to Sammy's house, and they recorded a bunch of demos, and then they went to Skywalker Sound and made a full album, which came out in June of 2009. They played the kind of the late night circuit, touring around. They did a short tour of, like, smaller venues. I saw them at the fucking Irving Plaza in Manhattan. It was small. I mean, it was crazy. Did you go with me, Dave? I can't remember. Did you come with me to Chickenfoot?
I don't think I saw them at Irving Plaza.
No, you didn't see
them. But I know I saw them on the first tour.
You saw them on the first tour, but not on Irving Plaza. Oh, wait. You know what? I think you went with me to the Beacon.
Maybe. I don't. Was that? I know I saw them in Connecticut, but that may have been the second tour. Well, that may have been the second tour. That may have been the Chickenfoot 3 tour when I saw them at Mohegan.
Yeah.
I know I saw them on the first tour.
Right. Okay. Now, the band, when they went on tour, they had like a set list that was interesting. Now, you think maybe they'd throw in some Van Halen, throw in some Chili Peppers, throw in some Solo Satriani. They didn't do that at all. They basically played the album with the bonus track, Bitten by the Wolf. And then they played a couple of covers, like they did Highway Star by Deep Purple, which was a nod to when Joe was in Deep Purple. Joe was in Deep Purple for a very short period of time. Also, they did Bad Motor Scooter, which is the old Montrose tune from Sammy's past. But no Sammy, no Van Halen, no Solo Satriani, no Chili Peppers. So that
what is it with Sam and bands
that
won't touch their old catalog?
Oh, it's unbelievable.
And that band was ripe for that.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Right? But no, they won't do it. And you'd think like a Van Hagar song would be perfect with Joe on guitar for them to cover.
Yeah,
it's just begging for it.
And you have
Mike and
Sammy there. Now, here's the thing about Chickenfoot, and this I'm going to say this right from the get-go. I look at Chickenfoot as an incredible missed opportunity because I thought Sam had an unbelievable vehicle here. Now, he's got the him and Mikey bond, okay? They're great on stage together. They sing perfectly in harmony. And you've got Joe Satriani and Chad Smith on drums, which is about as close as you're going to get to Eddie and Alex in the sense of musicianship, in the sense that they're of that quality of musicianship. Chad is an unbelievable drummer. Satch is an out-of-this-world guitar player. And they really, I thought, fit so well with Sam and Mike. I thought this band had unbelievable potential. I was blown away by how good they were. I was shocked. So now here's the funny thing. So now we all thought the name was always kind of funny, right? Chickenfoot. What the hell is that? Well, you know what?
Such an awful name.
Awful name. Just an awful shit name. So,
right.
But you know what a chicken foot is, Dave?
What is a chicken foot?
This is what I just discovered. I kept saying, what the fuck, chicken foot? Listen, I'm gonna read you the description of chicken foot, okay?
Okay.
When pants are so tight that the penis shaft is compressed into the testicles, the spandex-like pants conform into the shape of both the shaft and the testicles, giving the appearance of a chicken foot, three toes with the middle toe extended further downward.
I was never under the impression that they were naming the band after a crotch.
No, it's like camel toe or something.
No. I get that.
Yeah,
but I think I was always thought they just named it after the actual chicken foot and not like after the thing you're describing. Because Mike had said originally before they asked Joe to join the band, it was him, Sammy, and Chad, the three of them, and they just jokingly called themselves Chicken Foot. And then that was never meant to be
right.
The actual name of the band. But then when word started getting out, hey, these four guys are working together. They're in a band. It's being called Chickenfoot. Like the cat or the chicken was out of the bag.
Right.
And they said, all right, well, forget it. We're getting all this press with Chickenfoot. We'll just keep that as the band name. Because if we change it now, we'll lose the momentum.
Well, there's that. But, you know, if you think about all the fucking things that Sammy has, there's always some sort of secret sexual, name behind it. There's always something like that. Like with
I think it's your obsession.
No, it's not. I can prove it. The Yesup Company is pussy spelled backwards and What else? Pound Cake is always another reference. And then he's always got little, oh, you ate one too. There's always some kind of fucking simulations going on. Jesus Christ. So I was horrified when I read this. But anyway, I always thought, is this band serious or is this fluffy for fun? You know what I mean? Like...